Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our main event.
And he's ready.
Schedule for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. It's a three-way sudden death match.
He just fell asleep there. Sorry.
Coming first, Joe Dragon Enterprises presents your Dragon Champion, the Deutschland Dragon of Deutschland, and your number one contender, Grimm.
I guess Pete did make a comeback in spirit.
Spirit of delivery.
Buck, I played Skyrim for like a year. I'm the champion of dragons.
I'm not seriously, Buck. I have over 350 hours of gameplay. Do you know how much gameplay that is, Buck? I know dragons better than Joe Dragon thinks he knows dragons.
Alright, we're clearing the table. We'll play the game right now. I'm taking both of you on.
Oh, no, man. I'm too busy with Fallout 4.
You can't fight people in Skyrim, Buck. You don't even know.
There's a mod for it. Trust me.
Oh, I say there's a mod for it. I'm talking about the real game.
Polarize the figure of Grimm. Already has us all in our throats.
As far as having Joe Dragon at ringside and no disqualification match, he's certainly gonna help Grimm's chances. We know how much Joe Dragon loves to help out his little dragon gimp friend.
Coming to the ring next, accompanied by the Hall of Famer of the Uncaged Beast, Big Buddy Puma. He is one half of your team champions, Mr. WAW, Chris Shady!
These guys were out here earlier, and
the good times roll.
That crowd was hot for them. Now, these guys are excited to see them again.
You got that Chris Shady song everybody loves.
These people on the rhythm of
the rhythm of a Justin Bieber concert.
Hey, a lot better than that crap.
Oh, absolutely.
There you go, Shady helping everybody out. Rhythmic clapping, not the strong suit of these guys.
Joe Dragon disrespectfully waving that flag in BTP space.
USA! Joe Dragon is a patriot.
Let's call Joe Dragon a patriot.
Yes, from Germany.
No, he's a calm patriot, okay? He's a patriot. Dragon as their last name for no reason.
He is a dragon.
Look at him. He's Bowser. He's King Koopa. He's not a dragon. That's a part turtle thing.
But I think a Koopa could be part dragon, right?
I think it's a spike turtle.
Dragon turtle.
Okay, here we go. All right.
Joe Dragon Turtle. Hey.
I'd say ask Dennis Hopper, but let's
just
rest in peace.
No, man,
I love speed.
I love Dennis Hopper. Are you kidding me? Fuck this shit. Caps Blue Ribbon!
Swinging
this
that
match
flag.
Is going to be a barn burner, folks. Three-man sudden death, no disqualification. We got Grimm.
And their opponent from
Yeah, Thomas we haven't even had Gyles come out yet.
WAW Champion, Kevin Gyles!
WAW champion, wearing that belt,
still
proud.
That belt.
Still got that belt. Yeah, he makes WAW proud, Buck.
Got all the opinion shats. Not fuck those
Excuse
members
me.
At the table.
Here right? he comes. I said WAW, not Shats O'Bannon.
And I wasn't in that vote.
And he is the man, the champion, Kevin Gyles.
Oh, God.
And right now, he is staring the number one contender for his title, Grimm, right in the face.
How can he stare him in the eye when he's got no face?
What does that mean?
He's got a black stump for a head.
He said he was staring at him, not in the eye, Buck.
I'm not sure what you're saying, Buck. I'm pretty sure that Kevin Gyles has a face, and he's staring straight at Joe Dragon, ready to punch him.
He's Grimm. He's got no style. He's got no grace. This Grimm has no face.
Grimm has no face, that's right.
What are you talking about? Begs the question, how is Kevin Gyles going to make him leave in their match at Doomsday?
That is true.
And then she has to pin, submit, and make him leave.
I guess he's going to have to stab him in the neck.
Well, is the answer? It's not going to happen, guys.
He's going to have to get one of your four Mark said he's gonna go straight for the jugular.
You ain't getting my fork.
Say that now.
You're gonna have Dragon. A fucking fork in your neck.
Joe Dragon is getting winded waving that flag.
Joe Dragon just waving that flag uncontrollably.
Puma using that.
Did you see that?
Piece of toilet paper in it.
Wow. Disrespecting that Dragon Championship.
Standing it up for him, that's all.
Oh, yeah.
Nicely, Puma never done for him.
A nice glimmering brown shine.
He now has Hall of Fame shit on his stupid trash belt.
Well, Joe Dragon should be honored.
Wow. I don't know what you're looking for, hate. That belt or Kevin Giles?
That belt gets everything it deserves.
That's true. Yeah, it's true, because the Dragon title is like universally hated, while Kevin Giles just despised by me.
Yeah, it's just you, Buck.
Apparently it's just me. I'm the only one that understands this guy. It absolutely sucks. I'm the only guy.
It's just you, Buck. The match is on, folks.
Here we go. Our main event.
Contest.
Our main event for tonight.
Where does Kevin Giles on a shirt's baggy on him?
Look at this ring.
Shots at the big and tall.
How many X's are on a tag in that shirt?
Three.
And while we're on the subject, why is there a white hand on his dick? Explain that to me. It's weird. The big white hand. Grabbing his crotch all the time.
It's the long reach of America, Buck.
Okay.
It's the reach around of America.
The reach around of the...
Oh, speaking of reach arounds, we got a three-man collision in that corner.
Oh, Joe Dragon already making his presence known. Back shot.
Spine buster and a pin already trying to put away the champ early.
That's what Grimm's doing. He's picking out the weaker of the two. Working on him. Puma letting Joe Dragon up. Oh, that son of a bitch. Wow.
Joe Dragon.
Action on the floor.
Hitting Puma.
On the ring.
Now Shady giving it to Grimm.
Grimm's got like the stiffest punch you'll ever see or feel.
Oh, wow, what a devastating clothesline.
That was horrific. Shady might be out.
It's going to take a lot more than that to take out the WAW team champion, one half, of course.
And Grimm in control of this matchup.
I'm glad Kevin Giles got that faux hawk back. Gives him something to grab onto, you know.
That's
the stupid fin on top of his head.
With that white hand he has, Buck, something to grab onto?
Yeah. Not where Shady wants to be.
Oh no.
Wow. Right in the gut of Grimm.
Say, I don't know if he was aiming for that, but whatever.
Well, he was obviously aiming for Grimm.
But stiff kick, no matter what.
Shady still felt the brunt of that. While Grimm was choking him, I mean, if he gets kicked in the face, he pulls back Shady's head. Doesn't exactly help Shady at all, really. And now, Giles in control of this match.
Giles really moving this ring.
You're right.
Stacking him up now. This ring's gonna flip over if he hits that corner.
That would be one hell of a
look out.
Uh-oh, this impact is not gonna be nice. Good thing that Shady got out of the way.
I'm waiting for that pole to just implode on himself. Ah, big chop by Shady. Lighten him up. Oh, wait a minute.
Jump, Giles, jump! Jump, Giles, jump!
You're not me. Hold up the neck. You'll never be
good. Oh, that was
alright. Now these guys taking turns.
Are they playing horse? They're playing horse with Grimm.
Let's see what happens. Giles has an H.
Does he have an H? I'm not even sure how this works. I mean, I've played horse in basketball, but in wrestling?
Shady's chop was stiffer.
I see.
Double.
Now Giles. Now Gyles has to create a slip of shot.
Can we get a translator in there and ask Grimm which is worse?
No.
The audience and us will be the judge of that.
Nope. Gyles has HO. Gyles is a hoe.
I'm not sure who the winner of this, but I can tell you who the loser is. It'd be definitely Grimm right now.
That's true, though.
His chest is caving in. Look at Shady go.
Channeling his inner Nagasaki.
I remember Nagasaki.
Oh, God.
Kick to the chest. Wonder what he's up to these days.
Probably drinking some sake.
Probably enjoying some sushi rolls. This is sashimi.
I'm not gonna join this little racist little thing you guys got. Probably, you know, just call me to do that. Like any other.
Buster from Shady.
Yo, Dragon.
He wants a taste.
A constant pain in one's ass.
And a big running knee from
Grimm. Needs to get the hell out of there.
Say, Gyles must have the most devastating corner combo I've ever seen.
Absolutely.
He just smacks him in the face with every part of his body. Knee, foot.
I don't need that picture in my face, thank you.
Hey, you created that one, bud.
Now there's two.
These two have collided before.
Oh, and it's been awesome every time. Oh, man, he's gonna break down.
Whoa. The power of Kevin Gyles. Pushing over Mr. WAW.
That's funny because he's not a pushover.
This is getting physical. This is getting real physical.
Joe Dragon tending to Grimm right now while these two face off in the ring.
We have a shootout at the OK Corral.
What a strike to Shady's face.
Two desperados.
Looks like Shady has something up his sleeve.
A smack to Gyles' face.
That one hurt my grandma.
Sorry to hear about that.
Yeah, it's okay. I'll send her a card.
Wow.
What am I gonna talk?
Can we get a three count? And no, we do not get a three count.
Grimm is still staggering. Still trying his bearings about him. Voracious beating from both these guys.
Took a huge beat.
And a reversal from Shady, knocking Gyles into the corner.
What the hell is Gyles going for there?
Oh, Shady. We've seen him do this before.
Stacking them up.
Like stacking two.
Now Grimm in the ring, going for a clothesline, missing.
Gyles still wipes in that corner.
Gyles looks like he's...
Now he's
tired to get out of that corner himself and
setting up both men into the corner.
Wait a minute.
Driving those knees into Gyles. Gyles.
And that's two.
Brutal.
Double knee thrust in the corner. Joe Dragon barely waddling into that ring.
How desperate is Joe Dragon? Make sure Grimm wins this thing.
One term that can describe Joe Dragon is stunning desperation. Just look at him.
Can't argue.
Can't argue that.
Dead on.
Can't argue.
That's the most realest thing you've said all day.
Thank you, bud.
Oh, boy.
Uh-oh. EDT to both of his opponents.
Two for the price of one.
Holding his own against the number one contender and the champion.
That's how good Shady is.
Shady in control of both of these monsters.
Get him by the faux hawk. That stupid fan on top of his head. Now Joe, making sure he didn't go anywhere. Look at Shady go.
Joe so Dragon trying to get himself involved.
Photo.
Look out.
Oh my god.
How awesome was that?
Joe Dragon got dropped on his turtle spike dragon ass.
That looked like it sucks.
That was beautiful, folks. Can we turn that into a gift?
I hope so.
Oh my god, I can watch that for hours.
Puma drop kicking Joe Dragon.
Jumped on him.
Puma adding insult to injury.
Good god.
Whipping Joe Dragon with a flagpole.
Probably shouldn't have whipped that flag around too much.
You wore it out. Now it's worn out on you.
Incredible. Yes. Joe Dragon.
I would be. I'm in tears from laughing my ass off.
Chris Shady taking a double choke stand. Both of his opponents trying to pin him. This is one hell of a match, folks. This is what WAW is about.
Absolutely, Castle. Abso-freaking-lutely.
This is about Joe Dragon crying.
You get a camera shot of Joe Dragon crying?
Yeah. We need a medic.
Oh, never mind. I'll watch this shootout right now.
We need a dragon.
Big uppercut. Nah, just a nurse. And I mean a school nurse, not a real nurse.
I thought you were talking about, like, beach or something.
What the hell are we talking about? I have no idea. We got a match here, folks.
Bowser trying to steal Peach.
Oh, I get it. I get it.
Both men colliding into each other. That is the first double clothesline of the night.
Wait, Chris Shady going to the top rope.
Oh, no. Oh,
wait a minute.
What is
Chris Shady? Wait, Joe Dragon getting up in the air.
How is Joe Dragon on his feet?
The dragon exacting his revenge right now.
Joe Dragon channeling his inner ultimate warrior.
Chris and his Shadys.
And tripping off of the ring apron.
That could have been horrible.
That was already great as it was.
Anyway. Shady not where he wants to be right now.
Oh no, what has Grimm got planned
for? Perched on the top rope with Grimm coming up after him.
Come on, Grimm, take it up!
Oh, knock him into the audience. Oh, in the honor.
Crush those little kids.
Shady. These guys are both in a bad spot, but now Gyles. Oh no! Oh no!
Emphasis on the doom.
Oh, the Tower of Doomsday. Everybody from the Doomsday main event just killed on impact.
That was a tower on the road for Doomsday.
All these men. Down. They're all down. Who's going to get up first? The ref, has the ref even started the count?
Triple threat. Someone's got to win this thing.
Yeah.
Someone's got to win this thing.
Someone's got to win this thing. Hopefully Gyles.
Shady!
This crowd is behind Chris Shady.
Yeah, this crowd really wants to see Chris Shady take the belt.
Down on our line, we're in a title reservation though.
Do these guys even know that Kevin Gyles is right behind? Oh, Gyles, stumbling.
Oh God, here we go.
Now Grimm, the monkey in the middle.
Oh, and he just took the middle down.
That monkey's a gorilla. You do not want to piss him off.
You got that right, Buck. I do not want to piss off Grimm at all, but Grimm is in trouble now.
Wait a minute.
Airplane. Oh, wow. That was a twirling TKO from Shady.
He's still got another monster to deal with if the other monster gets up first.
Are you talking about Joe Dragon?
Yeah.
More like a monster.
Going right again, but he's got to look out. Joe Dragon is lurking.
He's definitely smelled cheesy.
He's lurking all right. Is that from, like, cheese doodles on the hands?
Munster cheese.
Oh, okay. There you go. You're talking about, like, the cheese
Gyles got a hand on him.
Oh, no.
Think about that triple threat.
So Gyles is telling Chris Shady that they're going to work together against Grimm right now.
What's going on?
Gonna do that.
He's loading the shotgun.
Got the back fist all loaded up.
Oh, here we go. Oh, no!
Friendly fire!
No. Friendly fire!
Oh, no.
Now, Grimm.
Chris Shady just got clocked. Shady is down right now, and we got Kevin. Oh, no.
What was that? What the fuck?
Kevin Gyles. Had Grimm. Grimm slipped through his fingers.
Hold on. Didn't slip out of that. Double arm DDT. Grimm's got wherever he wants him. He's got to roll him over. Shoot that half.
It's not easy.
Looks like Grimm's going to win this, but no.
Oh,
it's like trying to roll a whale into the friggin' beach. Just couldn't do it.
George Costanza did.
Shady took a devastating punch.
What's
and now, and he just saved the match.
Saved the match. There it is, folks.
Meanwhile, we're trying to save the whale still. Just roll him out of there.
He's a marine biologist, folks. His name's Chris Shady.
God damn it, you're humanitarian. Chris Shady. backing him up into the corner. Uh-oh. Look out! What is this? Oh my god!
Grimm now going for that cover.
Now Gyles breaking it up. This is anyone's game at this point.
Yeah, you're right, absolutely right.
This could go on all night with these guys.
And it might, folks.
Everyone on top of their game. Peak of their career.
Double check the length of this match, folks, because I am not sure how long this is going
to
go.
This might go to time limit. He's on the ropes. Another parquet slam.
He's going for that cover. Of course, Joe Dragon's on the apron. What is he doing? What is he doing?
This could be considered suicide.
Kevin Gyles had this one right now. And now Joe Dragon up on the apron, face to face.
Get the hell down, Gyles.
Gyles got to push Joe Dragon off that ring apron.
Grimm's up right now. Grimm is up right now.
Go ahead, Joe. Don't even listen to me. This isn't going to end well.
Just kind of hoping he gets hurt. I mean,
wait, look, BTP.
BTP got the legs of the dragon, turtle.
Oh my god.
Oh, oh tripping him out.
Good god.
He's collapsing on the floor.
And now, this is like sitting on. Sight,
just like I did with him.
And now Gyles
waves a flag.
The Kakarajo Bay while Puma is bouncing on Joe Dragon.
And Grimm.
Like a trampoline.
Grimm is in the ring. He could be submitting. He's trying to grab the ropes.
Grimm might tap out here.
BTP needs to pay attention.
BTP sitting on Joe Dragon, teabagging him.
Teabagging Joe Dragon.
Teabagging
him. He's tapping.
And Grimm just tapped. Grimm just tapped as Joe Dragon gets pink eye.
Winner of your match, Kevin Gyles.
Oh my god, humanity.
I'm surprised they didn't get their pubic hair and put it on his face.
That is disgusting. That is disgusting.
Into a gorilla.
Yeah, you know, sometimes you take things too far.
Hey, man.
Way too far.
That's the next step. That's the next step. You get bored doing the same things all the time.
And in the Dragon Championship.
Wait, look at Gyles. Look at that.
The look at the stage.
Please compare belts. Show everyone that that's a piece of crap compared to the WAW Championship.
What is that great for?
I really hope Kevin Gyles back fists the Dragon Championship.
Joe Dragon. Looks like he's acting like he's got his child in his clutches.
Gyles?
Begging him.
I believe it's Gyles.
You may have just made him submit. You might, just might, be able to pin him. But you can never make him bleed. And you will never be able to do all three in one match. You're losing your title, boy.
Nobody makes Grimm bleed his own blood.
I don't know how you make Grimm bleed unless you take off an article of clothing or just hit him in the neck.
Like we were saying earlier, you gotta stab that guy in the neck.
Don't play that flag, no.
Kevin Gyles standing tall.
Wow. Sometimes a person will say, well,
wait, what?
I guess
wait,
I'm going to hell, but I don't mind because that's where all my friends are going.
What is this? What is this? What? Johnny Psycho!
Shut up. Came from the streets.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry I'm late. I had to tell Christian Shane that it's not a good idea to convert to being a Muslim. I spent the past 4 hours with a crying Christian saint in Lowell, Massachusetts, and got stuck on some traffic on 93, so I'm a little late, but it's okay because the show doesn't start until I get here, because I am the beginning, the middle, and the end of the show. Riddles, you are a goddamn moron. Shut your mouth, you lisp. Get your Dragon Championship out of here. That's the closest you'll ever get to the WAW Championship. Rocco, why don't you come on upstairs? I think we need to talk about something, buddy.
Yeah, really, like, where were you? Got some explaining to do.
Puppies, but you were with Shane? Huh? With Shane?
Rocco's ready to go home. You cheated on Rocco.
Rocco looking nice and comfy.
Yeah, really.
Listen, Rocco, I don't think it's a good idea that we're both in the same match at the same time. I mean, to be honest, it's kind of stupid. I mean, 10 years ago, it was cool when we fought each other and stuff like that, but we've grown up a little bit since then, so I don't think it's the best of ideas. I think we should try and divide and conquer instead of going after the same thing. Why are you limping?
We had a tag team match. Conway tried to break my leg, and we won still. We're still 2-0 this year.
And by
we,
ooh, means
we won. And I wasn't even here. That's how good he is. Yes.
I guess I should fill you in. I called the Dirty Dealer because Gabby was still banging BTP later, and since she tried to screw us last week, the good news is we're not going to be in the same match at Doomsday. You are going to get back what's yours because you got screwed at the universe stroke. You are now in the peer title match.
Oh.
Surprise when you show up late, guys.
You don't, I don't know if you remember. You were drunk.
Thanks for showing up late.
You played ETA 5 and you won the contest. So. 99. Yeah, 99.
All right, sweet. So now we can be a dynasty?
Yes, because...
A Yi dynasty.
Taylor already said we could be the first team enter the team tournament starting next year. So, we're gonna win the Doomsday Ladder match, you're gonna win the pair title, we're gonna win the team tournament, and that Lord of the Ring, we're gonna have all the gold.
Because spoilers galore, people.
I remember that one time you had all the gold, but that guy, I don't think he was out of shape. What's his name? No gimmicks?
Old News?
Now you're... Governor Flax knows his name.
Now you're naming his name, yeah, Staples.
That's his name. Oh, is he still around?
I don't know.
He broke his hip. That's what happened.
You only have one hip.
You're part of this now. You joined us last week, Governor Flex.
Bye, Dick Fury.
Governor Flex.
I guess you got kicked out.
That'll be a Walking Dead reference.
All right, well, let's get going. These guys want to go home. They got EBT cards suspended. It's the 5th, right? Today's the 5th. Did you guys already spend it all?
It's 5th, Miss Everybody. There's no lows.
All right, let's go.
You know, I feel like there's a lot unsaid here.
Oh, wait, we're not done for tonight.
There you go.
We're not done for tonight. That's that music. So, since I got you in the pair match, how about you help me out by taking out the other guy in the ladder match? I already broke Pyro's leg. Yeah, I broke this leg. So how about you take out the wannabe hired gun, Derek Conway, and let's send this tonight so I can just climb that ladder and help you win the pair title.
Sweet.
So he's got the balls to come out here, Conway. Sweet. We're challenging you to a one-on-one match right here.
Right now.
We are challenging him to a one-on-one.
Yeah, this is a package deal.
Nice pajamas. Is this how Johnny Cycle dresses every day? Is that like his clothes?
I don't know. I mean, Rocco looks comfy. Johnny Cycle looks
Conway
like
even
Superman or something.
I didn't even know this was happening.
Let's go!
Oh, we're getting a bonus match apparently? Yeah, we already had a main event, but now I guess we are getting a bonus match. A main event. Conway was already out here earlier tonight.
Red Bubble Duck Club! $24.99!
That son of a bitch! Always putting himself over. Is that a Bullet Club shirt? No. It looks like one.
Offended.
The guy was just wearing a Buck the Rock shirt. He's got a...
You're offended because he's wearing a Bullet Club shirt?
Asshole!
Gyles, clearly tired from the last match. Why would Conway do that?
You! What are you doing
That's
this?
What I said. That's what I said.
I don't want you up here.
You should be up here.
You don't even like Conway. It makes no sense.
I am solely in the Cam Dry Cycle right now. That backstab son of a bitch.
Are you kidding me? It's your best friend.
Ex-best friend.
Why?
Kevin Gyles, that hack over me?
I told you to go up and you said no, but.
Kevin, quick, give it a statutory ape versus asylum, but no. No. That elbow into that walk up, just loosen the grip, turns into stand switch. These two jockeying for position.
Wow. Trying to psych each other out. Conway asking for a test of strength. Goose Cannon going off now.
How's that for a test of strength, huh?
There's no test of strength. It was disrespect.
Testing the strength right now.
He just hammered into the mat. He just caught him into confusion.
What a clothesline from Johnny Psycho.
What a green hat.
My new best friend, Johnny Psycho, laying out Conway. Huge clothesline.
Can't believe you turned on him that quickly.
Didn't take much. I hate Gyles that much.
He really didn't take anything. He didn't do anything.
Oh, yeah.
That's it.
Come on, Rick. Conway in complete control right now. They're both not even dressed to wrestle, and they're just ready to wrestle.
Yeah, never mind Thomas Andrews. These guys are always ready to go. Psycho showed up in a freaking cape. That's how ready he was to go.
Yeah, he was just missing a helmet.
Jawbreaker is Eric Conway.
That would really put the whole outfit together, wouldn't it?
That's a nice.
Look at this.
European in the Conway's hands.
I do get it.
These guys going back and forth, just trying to get these quick pins on each other.
Turn fire there.
Oh, they're returning the favor.
These two have a lot in common.
What, driving that knee right into the face.
And Conway came in as Arco. He's always compared to Johnny Psycho. And always hate at him. The two of them fight each other years later.
That's true, Buck. I did see a lot of similarities when Conway first started. And he was Arkham.
Since then, he's really grown into his own. Two of them still very, very similar styles.
Oh, and a cradle.
Nice cradle! Nice cradle! Psycho got him!
Oh, unbelievable. Grabbing the pants.
Rolling in here, Gianni Psycho!
Friends, zero. Should have picked me, kid. I would have took you right to the top.
I gave you the chance to go up there, but you said no.
Yeah, I specifically heard that.
Conway's mom now.
Now he must be calling his grandmother because this one is over.
Call his mama.
Somebody's got to call his mama.
There's more talking. Oh, Gabby, let's
go. What, you mad? Gabby came back, you mad?
Oh, Gabby's here.
Sleeping with towels around here.
She's just sleeping with me, she's not sleeping with him. Gabby! Gabby! You know what? Gabby, it's okay. You take your team to victory. You take your victory. victory tonight.
I beat you guys.
Because the next time, when it comes to tag matches, that I step in the ring with you two, it won't be him. Because he'll be having the team title. Sorry, not the team title. That beautiful WAW Championship. But Asylum, when it comes to the team tournament, you're going to have to go through me and the man who has freaky talk strength. Because I would do everything in my damn power to make sure you don't.
Wow.
So go home. With your jean grabbing shit. Get out of here. Go home. Nobody wants you.
Bringing in our king.
That's how Rocco likes it.
That cheater hit all of you. All you get.
Fuck, Buck.
He's mad at you because Buck. You chose the Gyles.
I don't want him to hurt himself. I love you, Buck. Buck, come on.
You gotta remember.
Come on, Buck.
Team elsewhere.
Yep. Come on, Buck. All
right.
Buck.
I want my Fuck the Rock shirt back, all of them. The Fuck the World, the great gray one. The gray one was nice, man.
That's nice, Buck.
Custom made, Chats.
Folks, that was a great edition of WAWF.
Absolutely. What hell of a show.
What hell of a bonus main event that just came out of nowhere.
Yeah,
so we're
really
going to have another awesome hard-hitting show on the way to Doomsday next week, so make sure to tune in for that one. I'm Darren Castle. This is Buck. He's really hurt from his friend Conway doing nothing wrong to him at all.
My feelings are hurt.
And Shats O'Bannigan.
And we'll see you next time. This is WAW Aftermath.